conditions, like if there is any change in this condition or if there is any change in this increment or decrement part. So how to solve those type of problems we have already seen in our previous lectures. Now we'll see this variant where change in this initialization part itself. So for this, so this is nothing but iterations, values of I. So number of iterations are, so how many iterations will be 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on k. And here we need to insert I values. So let us take iterations and I values. So for the first iteration, what is value of I? So value of I is initialized to n by 4. So it will be n by 4. So I is incremented by 1, and during second iteration you need to add 1 to the previous I value, because I is incremented by 1. So previous I is n by 4 and incremented by 1. During third iteration it will be n by 4 plus again add 1, that is 2. During fourth iteration, previous value is n by 4 plus 2. So it will be n by 4 plus add 1 to previous value, that is n by 4 plus 3. And so on. During kth iteration, it will be n by 4 plus. So here if you observe, during fourth iteration, value of I is 3. So here during kth iteration, value of I will be k minus 1. Okay. So this is nothing but, so here I equal to n by 4 plus k minus 1. During this fourth iteration, I value equal to n by 4 plus 3. So just write them in this table, n by 4 plus 1, n by 4 plus 2, n by 4 plus 3, and so on, n by 4 plus k minus 1, which is, the condition is less than or equal to n. So here this is nothing but your I value. What is the condition? I is less than or equal to n. So take this I value, n by 4 plus k minus 1 less than or equal to n. So this can be written as k minus 1 equal to n minus n by 4. And k less than or equal to 3n by 4 plus 1. Okay. So if you take upper bound of this, then you will get time complexity as, for 3n by 4, upper bound is n. So this can be written as big O of